Hey there! I wanted to give you a look at a new tool I have in the shop, and that is the Ryobi 40-volt lithium brushless cordless snowblower. And this has a 20-inch cleaning path, and for all of us that live up in the North Country where we get a good amount of snow, this is a handy thing to have. This is not for busting through what the plow leaves you or anything like that, but this is for taking care of snowfalls that are like 6 to 8 inches or less deep. It's been working good for me. I'm going to show you a little video here in a little bit about me going across actually a yard with heavy wet snow and showing you how everything throws. It does include two of the Ryobi 40 volt high capacity batteries. It has two of those in there, and each battery has a fuel gauge on it. And it includes the charger, and it includes a storage pack. This storage pack you can actually clip onto the handle anywhere you want, and that will let you carry your extra battery with you if you so choose. The snowblower does have numerous features. It has two headlights, which are actually really bright. You wouldn't think you need them, but up here in the North Woods, the sun goes down at about 4 o'clock in the afternoon at this time of year when it's snowing, and the lights are nice to have. If you don't want to use the lights, there's a switch right here that you can turn the lights on and off with while you're operating with. It has a chute adjuster that's right underneath the main handle. You can quickly adjust the chute in any direction you want to move it to instantly. That helps out to start the snowblower, and I don't have a battery pack in it right now, and I'll put one in just a second, but to start the snowblower, all you would do is push this switch down and pull back on the safety lever, and that will get the snowblower started up for you, and that will allow you to run it. It's easy to store the snowblower if you just pull these levers out, snap them out. You can fold the entire handle forward, and then you can carry it using this really nice carry handle behind the snow chute, and that's right here. And you can adjust the height of the snow throwing by just moving this, and it locks into place, and then it won't be pushed back when the snow is coming out of here. And it does actually throw snow really hard. I was really surprised by it. This isn't the only 40 volt cordless snowblower that I own. I own one made by another brand, and that works very well. I'm not talking bad about the other brand of 40 volt cordless snowblower that's out there. What I am going to say though is that for some reason, however it is in the design, this Ryobi model does throw it a little bit farther and a little bit harder. They both do a great job. The Ryobi just does it just a hair better in my experience of using both. So you want to adjust that back and forth. You can pick it up with the carry handle, and I'm going to show you where the batteries go here in a second, and then I'm going to let you hear it run. So let me clean this stuff out of the way, and we'll grab a battery pack, and I can show you how that goes in. Right here on the back of the tool, you will see this large door here, and you'll take your battery pack, and you'll insert it in the correct orientation, and wait till it snaps in place, and the lid's spring-loaded, so it just falls right over the top of it, and you know that you got your battery in there. And that all sits right down there. It's real easy to see. So we'll make sure that you guys can hear everything. And it's really, really quiet. It's not like starting a gas lawnmower or a gas snowblower either, where you have to, you know, pull back on your lever and then reef on a pull start over and over and over again until it finally starts. All this is you press this little button here and you pull back, and you're going to hear it start, and the brushless motor will start running. You can see, if you can hear me over that, it's pretty quiet, but we're in a shop here, so it's going to be a little louder. But you can see that rotor down there is spinning quite fast, and you can see that the headlights have come on, and they're real bright. You can turn those on and off as you wish. And turning it off is as simple as letting go of the lever, and then it stops running for you. I'm going to cut to a video of me pushing it across a yard with about 6 inches of heavy wet snow. It had been raining here on top of the snow, so it's a little heavier than you really want to plow with this thing, but I thought I'd give it a good rugged test and just see how it held up, and it's still going good for me. So when we come back, we'll see how you like that video. Okay, well that was real easy. I brought it back inside. Because of the way that the wheels here are set back, it's easy to take up and down steps like off of a deck or off of a porch. I bring it inside every time when I'm done with it, and I put it on a boot mat so that all the water can drain off of it. I suppose you could leave it in a garage or a shop outside at regular cold temperatures if you wanted to, but you want to make sure that if you do so, that when you do leave it outside, and even when you bring it inside, what you want to do is you want to make sure that this rotor here is completely clear of snow and ice, or what's going to happen, same thing that happens with any other kind of snow blower, is that when you finally start to use it again, it's going to be frozen solid and it's not going to want to run. So I hope you enjoyed this look at the Ryobi Lithium 40-volt brushless cordless snowblower.